smile.
Well, it's not every day that you pack up and move factory.
13 years.
13 years.
The last day at Vineland.
Wow.
We moved in here. So, 2010.
Wow.
After an economic crash, we didn't know what was going to be happening in the marketplace. We hunkered down, scaled down, and decided to see what was going to happen next. And what happened next was amazing. We found new inspiration. We found a cozy place that everybody liked working at. It was kind of small and intimate, but ultimately it worked for everybody. So,
you guys had arguably your best years here.
I would say. It just kind of went by fast. We didn't even realize how much stuff we really accomplished here. We did 13 years. What did we do? Probably 8 or 10 NAMM shows. We released the power station here. We released the LX2 here. We released the power load here.
The ether.
The ether was developed, designed and developed here. And we redesigned and re-released the SIG-X. Then I started doing contract work for Synergy, and we developed the SIN 1 and the SIN 2, the SIN 5050, and then did modules for them. But through it all, we sort of kept everything really tight and organized so we didn't accumulate a bunch of stuff.
All right, take me through here. What do we have going on here? We had almost like the accounting department over here in the corner.
Accounting, shipping and receiving, design, development, graphic arts. Everything going on right here. We reduced it down to our most talented, most productive, most tightly integrated people came to this facility with us. And we had less people, and it was more productive, and it was more of an interactive team. And I think that's a real big part of why everything seemed to always work so smoothly, because everybody communicated well, everybody knows what their responsibility is, everybody knows how to cover for somebody else. And then when COVID happened, it was like a team of thoroughbred racehorses. And it's like, okay, you guys are all going to go home and sit in your stalls for 6 months.
Yeah.
You wanted a vacation? You got one. And then, yeah, after the lockdown was over, we came in and we started wondering, okay, now what's going to happen? We have all these back orders. We have all this inventory. And as I was saying that to myself, purchase orders started rolling in from the various dealers, and we're like going, oh. We went from the whole team grinding at maximum efficiency and ability to stopping for 6 months or whatever it was and doing virtually nothing, to putting on the gas and going right back to where we left off before the shutdown.
Yeah.
It was intense. And so there was a lot of excitement from that. Mm-hmm. And out of that, you know, when things are going well and there's a lot of excitement and everybody's all pulling together, you know, it just sort of inspires new ideas, and we get feedback from customers about what kind of things they would like to have, and that just spawned more ideas for product.
Yeah.
And now we've got a dearth of product designs stacking up.
But then you have this little thing of relocating entire factory to kind of deal with this week.
The property that this facility is in got sold, and the new owners decided to demo. We had been talking about moving to a bigger facility because we were completely out of space for so long, and we were thinking that we were going to do it probably 6 months from now. But that timeline got pushed ahead 6 months, so here we are.
Yeah, yeah.
Like ripping it down. We got a new facility already lined up and ready to go. So while that's going on, still wrapping up product development on existing things. As long as the computers are plugged in, as long as the test gear is connected, as long as, you know, the soldering iron is available, as long as I've got the basic tools I need to work on stuff.
Oh, look, projects are disappearing off of your table as we speak.
I was just going to say, as long as I've got...
Look at this.
As long as I got tools and materials to work on, I'm going to keep doing it until they start taking them away. So I guess they're taking them away.
Wow.
You are watching, and I don't say this to brag, you are watching the most finely tuned, focused, talented team of people that any manufacturer could hope for.
So it's like you got an Indy 500 pit crew here.
Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt. So we had just gotten some prototype boards in, and we're evaluating the prototypes for an about-to-be-released new product that probably everybody knows what it is, but I'm not going to say right now because I don't want to jump the gun.
You've been shut down, literally.
I guess I'm through evaluating that board assembly for right now.
All right. You want to take me through here and show everybody where everything was? People have seen this area a lot if they've been following the channel at all.
Yeah, there isn't really a department.
Yeah.
There's several people work at this area. Mm-hmm. I used it for doing some of those demo videos and high-watt videos and those kind of things. I used it for that. We test prototypes here. We do QC for production here. And this is all final assembly and pre-production testing where...
So we had Masa Station and Jose Station.
Right. And they would build the units and get them ready to cook. And they would do an initial burn-in test. And then everything would go up on the burn racks and sit for hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, whatever, until they're cooked and ready to do final QC. And then whoever's available to do final QC... And there's three different people that can do that job, will do that. If they're really busy running a follow-up production, and my design assistant is working on a critical PCB set design that needs to get sent out for board assembly or for board fabrication really quickly, and I'm the only one left, and I'm the one that does QC. If I'm the one that's doing the QC or the R&D or the time-critical operations, then he does the QC, you mm-hmm. know? It's mm-hmm. just, it's whoever's available on deck to do that task today, that's your task.
Yeah.
It's all happening too fast for us, any of us, to really wrap our minds around what's going on intellectually and emotionally, you know? So we're just jamming to the finish line.
Yeah.
And we'll sort it all out later. Wow. Just wow. We're gonna get into the new place, and then we're gonna just start thinking about what we've accomplished and what we're gonna accomplish next. It's gonna be, I don't even know what it's gonna be like.
Yeah. Here's the office, overseen by Saint Jimmy.
Yep.
A to-do board, calendar, and a whole lot of Fryette gear.
Yeah. So everything in this room is now gonna have three different places for it to go.
Will you have like kind of a demo room area?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. So tomorrow the trucks come, load stuff out, and then the next time we get together, we'll be watching the trucks come into the new place, and we'll do a walkthrough of the new place before it really gets populated. And then we'll be releasing the first of the several new products that we're going to release out of there. That's going to be happening right away. We're going to be wrapping that up. In fact, some of the suppliers that have the parts already to ship to us to do the first build of the next product are just waiting for us to give them approval to take the trucks over to there and drop it off there rather than bring it here and move it over there.
Oh, hot damn.
So, yeah, a lot of logistics stuff happening to make everything go smooth. And wow.
Wow. All right. Well, wow. Wow. A farewell to Vineland.
Farewell to Vineland.
What do you remember most from this factory?
Well, testing stuff with Steve, you know, at the bench, and just in general, the cozy vibe. Two of us in the office, you know,
working on
your products. So, yeah, stuff like that. I really like the vibe and yeah, it was just a cool space, you know, but also at the same time, of course, looking forward to moving into the new building and moving forward. So I'm excited about the future.
Jose!
Hello!
So what do you remember most about the North Hollywood place?
The most thing we remember is when we moved the first time again from Burbank to North Hollywood.
And what'd you think about it when you moved from Burbank to North Hollywood?
When we moved, I think we have a good chance to have a new area, new nice area. But after a few years, everything changed. Yeah.
It was too small?
Too small, yeah.
Yeah.
Because the company is growing more, and we didn't have enough room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how long did you work at Burbank?
In Burbank, I worked for maybe like 7 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then we moved to...
So you were in the big factory.
Yeah.
You moved to the much smaller factory.
Yeah.
And now you're going to be in Chatsworth?
Chatsworth, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Now we were in Chatsworth. This place is bigger.
Yeah.
Twice bigger than North Hollywood.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Omasa.
Hello.
Hey. So what do you remember most from the North Hollywood factory?
Well, I cannot decide one, but you know, like Jose said, when we moved in to the North Hollywood, and then I felt, wow, it's a really small place, because you know we work at the Bourbon place, and then 3 times or 4 times bigger than the North Hollywood place.
Wow!
And then you know that I first thought about, oh, how can we work in this small place? And then, but you know, when we get used to it a little by little, and then, yeah, so we worked a lot of things, you know, in that small place. And then, you know, everybody, you know, work together, you know, very close to each other. But it was a really nice, you know, experience for me, you know, because my image, America, and then, you know, American company is big, the office is big, factory is big. But you know, I felt like I was working in kind of Japan, because Japan, you know, all the company and the office is much, much smaller than the US. Oh. So I felt like, you know, Japan and then, you know, like a family working together, kind of, you know, I feel close to, you know, everybody. Yeah, so we worked hard, but yeah, I had a really good, nice memory there.
And do you think that will change in Chatsworth, or will it stay the same kind of family feel?
I still feel family feel, because we struggled moving in, and then, you know, we all worked hard, you know, organizing thing. But I feel difference is, you know, of course it's much bigger. Much, much bigger than the North Hollywood place, and then, you know, we don't have to worry about the storage, and then, you know, where to put this thing, where to put that thing, you know, we don't have to worry about things. So I'm so happy with that. And then, so we used to work in Burbank, and the Burbank place was much, much bigger. And then when I first came here and then see the factory and the office area, I kind of remember when I was working in Burbank. Yeah, so I'm really happy with this office. Yeah.